Hello again, viewer. Do you feel weak or dizzy after having painkillers? While they can relieve us, many people avoid taking them as they do carry side effects. If you're one of these people, listen up. We've got some great natural alternatives for you. Number 1. Turmeric. Turmeric is a spice that contains a chemical compound called curcumin. It's a one-of-a-kind antioxidant that creates a protective layer around parts of the body. These layers prevent damage against free radicals, which are molecules that can decimate your body's tissue and cells. Curcumin can not only get rid of the pain, it can also destroy the bacteria and other microorganisms that may cause infection. According to a study, it was found that turmeric can help reduce joint pain in patients who have arthritis. One interesting thing about turmeric is that it's used in many recipes that are of South Asian and Middle Eastern origin. It's also known to help the digestion process and fight all sorts of stomach infections. In other words, this is one natural cure that you can actually ingest without facing any side effects. Moving on. If turmeric wasn't good enough for you, then here's another alternative. Number 2. Raspberry leaf. Raspberry leaves are a rich source of protein, nutrients, and antioxidants. All of these things are extremely useful when it comes to tackling infection as well as pain. Apart from that, they have anti-inflammatory properties, which help in fighting muscle spasms. Historically, this herb was used on expectant mothers as it helped in relieving the pain they might feel during pregnancy. As a result, raspberry leaves were nicknamed the women's herb. Raspberry leaves also contain a chemical compound known as fragrin. This helps tighten the muscles and soothe the pain. It also contains tannins, a compound that helps strengthen the uterus, thus helping women tackle period pain. Raspberry leaves are often considered home remedies for vomiting, menstrual cramps, and even diarrhea. One of the best ways to consume raspberry leaves would be through raspberry leaf tea. It's extremely affordable and it's found in supermarkets. With that out of the way, let's talk about our third natural remedy. Number 3. Cloves. You probably saw this one coming. It contains several antimicrobial factors. The most common usage of cloves as pain relievers is in the form of clove oil. It's often used for massages on patients who have arthritis or chronic pain. Cloves are also known to ease headaches, arthritis inflammation, and toothaches. This is because of a compound known as eugenol, found in cloves, which is a natural pain reliever. Rubbing a tiny amount of clove oil has also been known to temporarily ease toothaches. Although, we wouldn't consider this as a permanent solution. You can apply a little bit of clove oil on your gums before you go to the dentist. After all, it's more of a temporary healer. Cloves may also make you feel better if you're feeling nauseous. Apart from that, whole cloves can be good for a sore throat, but if you have a bad cough or throat infection, then it would be better to avoid it. We wouldn't recommend cloves to people with bleeding disorders as it can increase the amount of abnormal bleeding. Whoa, who knew that nature had such awesome remedies? Come to think of it, we aren't even done with the list yet. In fact, here's number 4. Heat and ice therapy. It's often recommended by experts to take hot salt baths in order to relieve stress. But guess what? Heat as well as cold therapy can help you tackle pain. If you have an injury or a burn, one of the quickest relievers of that pain may be ice therapy. As ice is a frozen water, it helps the body's muscles and tissues to relax. Ice is also known to stop external inflammation and infection that may be caused by injuries. Similarly, heat therapy can be useful when you have joint or muscle pain. It can calm stiff or sore muscles as well as reduce stiffness in the joints. So in case you have shoulder pain, you can consider taking a hot shower. Taking massages after said shower would also prove helpful in dealing with the pain. Heat also improves blood circulation of the body and prevents the formation of blood clots. While going through heat therapy, you have to keep a few things in mind. The first one being, you should be comfortable with the temperature. In case the temperature is too high, we suggest you avoid it, as you would risk causing burns to your skin. The second thing to consider when applying heat therapy is that you should never apply it to an open wound. Bacteria can enter the body through an external injury, and heating it would speed up the blood circulation, making it easier for the bacteria to enter your bloodstream and infect it. You don't want that. In the case of a wound, you can ice, which we stated earlier. The third thing that you might want to consider is the time. Heat therapy, when applied properly, can help ease the pain, but if you keep it for too long, you can get burns and rashes. So what can you do? Use heat therapy for a maximum of 20 minutes and never extend it. The idea behind heat therapy is to help ease the pain. Overheating may cause more problems. Keep the same thing in mind while doing cold therapy. If you keep an ice bag for too long on an injured part of your body, it can stop the blood circulation in that area. This can lead to the formation of blood clots, so keep it to a maximum of 20 minutes and avoid extending it. Now, let's go to number 5. Tai Chi. Yeah, you read that right. Tai Chi is a form of Chinese martial arts, originally practiced for its health benefits. Tai Chi has become very popular recently. People of all ages want to take part in Tai Chi, and many people claim that it's helped them shape a healthier lifestyle for themselves. In a recent study, 66 people with fibromyalgia were divided into two groups. One group was given Tai Chi classes twice a week, while the other did stretching exercises twice a week. The results were observed over a period of 12 weeks, and in the end, it was found that people who attended Tai Chi classes reported less pain, stress, and fatigue. Additionally, many researchers also agree that Tai Chi can help people with arthritis as well. So, in case you're having a problem with that knee, maybe you can consider joining Tai Chi classes. So, were you aware of all these alternate painkilling remedies? Have you ever tried any of these remedies yourself? Let us know in the comments section below. We would love to hear from you.
Enjoyed this video? Hit like, share, and subscribe to Bestie. Wait, what kind of bestie would we be if we didn't tell you about our other awesome videos? Go ahead, choose the left or right video and enjoy.